Hey, what's up guys, welcome back. You're watching for Rebooting. One day before we uploaded video for in-depth review of new Oxygen S15 port for OnePlus 9 RD. I am using that build from last 2 days and I got really amazed by this build because it's super stable with all working Oxygen S15 features. Such Oxygen S15 ports also available for OnePlus 8 9R, 9 Pro and OnePlus S3. So today we are going to check how you can flash this build on OnePlus 9 RD. For other OnePlus devices users, I have given the link of dedicated thread of their device. You can follow that thread for downloading all the necessary files and flashing instruction. Remember, this video is only for OnePlus 9RD users, but still some flashing steps may resemble with the mentioned devices, so you can follow this video at some steps only. For installation of such ported ROMs and the custom ROM, you must have the basic knowledge of unlocking bootloader, fastboot and ADB drivers installation of your PC. So if you are a beginner, I will recommend you to stay away from this video. The users who are still interested to try this flashing process, follow at your own risk. Who are not responsible for anything happens to your device. Please watch each and every part of this video carefully. I discuss everything, including what are the requirements, how to flash and how you can revert back to original stock ROM at the end of this video. So watch this video till the end. Now without further delay, let's get started. So what are requirements before you start the flashing process? Please take the full backup of your device because whole data of your device may get erased during this process. Actually, I did the dirty flashing of this ROM on my OnePlus 9RT. It's worked for me, but I can't guarantee it will work for other devices. Next, your OnePlus 9RT must be on the OxygenOS 14 V730 or 740 latest version. Other device users, please check the X-ray thread for your device to know the firmware base for flashing this port ROM. Don't try to flash this build over any custom ROMs. First of all, your device bootloader must be unlocked. Developer option of device must be enabled. You can turn on the developer setting by tapping 8 times on your version build number in the about device section. Then under the additional setting, you will now get the developer setting option. In this setting, toggle on the USB debugging option. Now you are good to go. You need one Windows PC with the system-wide fastboot and ADB driver installed. If you are using the Mac PC, then please install your Mac drivers. Windows PC users, if you still didn't install the fastboot driver, then follow this step. Download fastboot and ADB drivers version 1.4.3 zip file from the video description. Unzip it, you will get the new exe file. Double click on it. The new window will open. There it will ask for the installation of ADB and the fastboot drivers. Type Y and enter. Next, in the CMD, you will get the new prompt to install the device drivers. If you want to install your device driver, then connect your device to the PC and accept the next prompt by typing Y and then enter. That's it. Now your PC have all the necessary fastboot, ADB and the device drivers. Now you have to download the 2 different files for your OnePlus 9RT. Other device users, please download the mentioned file from the XDA developer link. For OnePlus 9RT, you need to download the Oxygen S15 V401 build zip file and another one is the fastboot flasher installer zip file. First, extract the Oxygen S15 V401 zip file. You will get another folder which contains the images and the version folder. Now extract the installer zip file within the Oxygen S15 V401 firmware folder which you extracted previously. Now you can directly copy the complete folder of Oxygen S15 V401 in the platform tools. For that, go to the C drive of your PC under the program files and in the platform tools folder, paste the file. Now take phone in your hand, power off it. Now long press the volume down plus power button to boot your OnePlus 9RT into the fastboot mode. Other device users, you have to know the hardware combo buttons combination to boot your device in a fastboot mode. First, we have to check if your device is properly detecting in a fastboot mode in the CMD or not. For that, open the CMD window within the folder of your firmware. You can either press the Windows key plus R key of your PC. You will get the small window at the bottom there. Type CMD and press enter. Or you can also press the Shift plus right key of keyboard and select the open CMD window from the drop down menu. Remember, don't use the PowerShell window, only CMD is recommended. Now type fastboot devices, then hit enter key, you will get your device ID in the CMD. Once it is get detected, type fastboot, reboot fastboot. You will see your phone will reboot to this screen, it's called as a fastboot D mode. Here tap on the language preferences as per your wish. Now again type the fastboot devices in the CMD and hit enter. Your device must be detected again with the serial number as you can check in the video. If your device is not showing in the CMD, you have to repeat the installation process of drivers on your PC. Keep your device connected to the PC in the fastboot D mode. Now go to your firmware folder. There double click on the install bat file if you are using the Windows PC. Or if you are using the Mac, then double click on the install.sh file. Now installer script will be automatically opens in the new CMD window. Here follow all the prompts as you will get. The first one is the language preferences. For the English, type 1 and enter. Next, press the enter key to begin the flashing process. Next, you will get the option to root your new Exynos 15 version. You can type Y if you want to root, or if you type N if you didn't. Next, again press the enter key and flashing will start. Lots of files will get flashed in your device. This flashing will take 10 to 15 minutes, so wait patiently. Don't remove your device or disturb it while flashing. After VV meta flashing, you will get the new prompt of flashing logical partition to the A or B slot. I recommend you to don't type anything, just press enter key. Again, some flashing of the files will start. After that, you will get the new prompt in the CMD to boot your device in a bootloader mode. Here, type Y and enter. Your device will boot to this bootloader mode. And in the CMD, remaining files like modem will be get flash. Now, get the prompt in the CMD to wipe your data. Remember, it's always recommended to wipe your data to avoid the conflicts or the bugs in the device after updating your port ROM. But I did the experiment by skipping the data wipe for my OnePlus 9RT, so I typed a N. Finally, you will get this message in the CMD firmware flashing is successful in the green color. Now type enter key, you will see your device will start to boot. It will take 1 to 2 minutes, you will see your device will boot with the new Exynos 15 boot animation. After booting, you can check your device is working perfectly or not. Check all the AI features of Exynos 15. Once confirmed everything is working, next is very important step for OnePlus 9RT. You need to boot your device again into the fastboot D mode. I already shown you how you can boot your device into the fastboot mode, so follow those steps and boot your device. Now connect your phone to the PC, go to the same firmware folder, there under the images folder, open the new CMD window. Now type the next command that you can check on the screen. And then drag my underscore manifest file from the images folder into the CMD and hit enter. Once flashing up manifest file gets done, type fastboot reboot. You will see your device boots back to the Exynos 15 again. This is additional step for OnePlus 9RT. I don't know it's mentioned for other devices or not. You have to check the flashing instruction given in the XDA thread for your device. That's it. Now you can enjoy all the new Exynos 15 features on your aged OnePlus devices. Steps I mentioned in the video are only for OnePlus 9RT, but you can use this video as a base for flashing of your device firmware on OnePlus 8T, 9R and 9 Pro because most of the steps are similar for all devices. But still, first check your device original XDA thread for installation and downloading of all the necessary files. Don't use the OnePlus 9RT files on your device, it's only given in the video description for OnePlus 9RT. You can only use the fastboot drivers files from the video description for installation of fastboot and ADB drivers. Last question may arise, how to roll back to the old Exynos 14 or the 13, whatever version you want. For 9RT, you can follow the iCard video link. In that video, I've shown how you can flash the old fastboot ROM on your device. That's the only way to roll back to the old version. I don't know what will be the procedure to roll back for other devices like 8T, 9R and 9 Pro. I always recommend you to users of 9RT and other devices, please follow this video at your own risk. This is all about for today's video. If you think this video helped you, then please do like and share this video, subscribe to our channel, press the bell icon for the notifications of our upcoming modding content for your Android devices. Thanks for watching, see you next time, take care, bye bye.